This UCSD TV program is presented by University of California Television. Like what you learn? Visit our website or follow us on Facebook and Twitter to keep up with the latest programs.
We are the paradoxical ape. Bipedal, naked, large-brained, long the master of fire, tools, and language, but still trying to understand ourselves. Aware that death is inevitable, yet filled with optimism. We grow up slowly. We hand down knowledge. We empathize and deceive. We shape the future from our shared understanding of the past. CARTA brings together experts from diverse disciplines to exchange insights on who we are and how we got here. An exploration made possible by the generosity of humans like you.
We live twixt the past and the future, and we live in the present. And those of us from Scripps, as climate scientists here, try to use our understanding of the present climate to try to answer the third of your questions: where are we going, at least in the climate area? And how will those changes impact us as civilizations? And we have learned what Yogi Berra knew all along, that prediction is very hard, especially when it's about the future. But as I started thinking about this conference, I understood also that understanding the past is, in this particular area, equally difficult. The reason is, I think, that paleoclimatology is probably the most difficult branch of climate science, because you need to know what modern science is saying about how the climate works, but you have to use data that you infer from proxies. So you need at least two, and usually many more, scientific disciplines to make sense of the climate in the past. But what we have learned is that it went through a tremendous series of changes in a different environment, but of a magnitude and scope and rapidity I think rivals what we will have in the future. So the question is, how did we get here? And how did our ancestors cope with these huge changes in climate? And that is the topic of this symposium. And Rick has put together an all-star cast of people who have studied this most difficult topic. So I have just a couple of questions about the relationship of the past to the future. How did our early, we are ice age creatures, and how did our earliest thinking ancestors survive their huge climate change? When we reached the present interglacial, the climate calmed down and we developed agriculture and a more stable climate, but were we more sensitive and to the changes, smaller changes of climate that have allowed us thus far to build our civilization? And so with those questions in mind, I'm going to start the conference, and I expect to have a great debate between the past and the future, and it will be mediated by the present.